Hello, buddy. Welcome to another video. Just a quick update to follow on where we were last week. You saw us actually starting to put the ceiling up using the bonding and try and get everything put in place. That didn't work. Unfortunately, the bond just wasn't enough to actually hold on to the ceiling plates, and this one came crashing down, unfortunately, after we took all the supports out. Slightly annoying because it meant going to get another panel, but I think we got away with it. Opted for dropping screws in instead, roughly all the way along the top here, at the lower sections of the sort of the ribs essentially across the ceiling. So a couple of screws into there, it's held it up fine. I put little white screw caps on as well, so it doesn't look too bad. But give me a quick pan over now, you can have a quick look. So there you go. Lights also installed. The screw caps don't look too unsightly. It's the lesser of two evils, I think, really. But yeah, quite impressed with the results. So what I'm going to do today is, if I just pan you up here, there we go. There's the vent and the hole in the ceiling to suit. So what I'm going to do is pop this trim on. So there we go. 3D printed little insert, which will cover the hole actually in the ceiling. It's just a trim piece, really, just to pretty things up where the vent sits. So let's try and get that installed, shall we? And I hope I'll get this done without too much traffic driving by. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to attach this up into there. And the 3D print's actually got a bit of a grain, so I'm actually going to make sure the grain matches the grain of the ceiling as well. It's just nothing too major, but it's just something I like to see done properly. So we know what it'll look like when it's pinned in, and what we'll do is we'll use essentially super glue, but it's known as sort of miter bond. It's essentially designed for sort of if you've got miters in houses and sort of cornices and stuff like that. A lot of them now are plastic, so this is ideal for actually bonding it on with. But it doesn't take much, just a little bit around the edges. Is all it'll take, and it actually comes with this, which is activator. Now super glue normally will go off itself, but with the activator it forms an instant hard bond. So literally just spray a bit of that on, line this up where it needs to be, because you only get one shot at this, and here we go. Press and hold for a second, and that's it fitted. And that will be a semi-permanent bond. It's very good at temperature resistance. You'd never get any problems with that coming off. I mean, I've used that stuff before for putting sort of the bottle foam planes together, and yeah, it handles all weather conditions and whatever you throw at it. It's a really, really strong bond. But that means now, nicely trimmed, finishes that part of the ceiling off lovely. But obviously what we've done, we've got the lights in there and all the bits and bobs, so have a look at this.
Let there be light.
One thing you probably will notice is it's quite a hard edge between the ceiling and the carpeted area. Now this front section here, that's actually a batten of wood that we've carpeted and actually pinned up to hold it. Because literally sort of from there back to about sort of 2.5 foot back, there's no actual support for the ceiling here, so it's got to have something to hold it up, and that just worked perfectly. Finished it off nicely. It also gives us something that we can hang a curtain rail to as well, which is going to be quite handy. But the edges, we've bought some essentially sort of rope, it's some sort of decorative stuff, and we're going to actually sort of glue that up and just use it to just finish the edge, so there's not that sort of hard line between it. I think it'll just finish off. It's just a trim piece, really. It's not functional at all. It's just something to pretty it up. But I'll go and grab it and I'll give you a quick demonstration and see what you think. So this is the edging trim that we've gone for. It's actually sort of decorative sort of rope for making sort of decorations and bits like that. But I thought it's ideal because it's similar sort of colour to the carpet, but not the same. But that'll just go up along the edge and just forms a buffer, takes the hard edge away from the ceiling. But so I've got to get some hot glue to get that off. I think that'll work perfectly. But once that's in, there's a couple of bits I need to do as far as getting some insulation in the back doors and getting some carpet on those as well. The side door will need insulating and carpeting, but once that's done, we're ready to get lino down on the floor. And then on to the next stage of the build, which is the furniture. Get the bed in, get the units put together. Getting alarmingly close to looking like a real camper. But watch this space, and we'll get that that video filmed as we make it. If there's any information that you want to know, drop a comment down below. I'll try and get back to you as soon as possible. Obviously, this is the first time we've ever done anything like this, and all of it's just based on general sort of picking up knowledge from around the internet. But as far as the results that we've got so far, we're absolutely blown away with the quality of the stuff that we've used. Definitely one thing we read first, long time ago when we were first looking at it, was don't buy the cheap stuff because it's really not worth it. And yeah, especially with the carpet, I can agree with that. I've seen quite a few videos of people actually having a nightmare actually getting this stuff to stretch. This was unbelievably easy to get up. As far as, like I said, the other bits and bobs go, most of it's just been, you know, sort of try it and see what it looks like, and I think we've come out fairly well with it. Certainly sort of the ceiling cladding, we were looking at doing the plywood, then we looked at doing, you can actually buy just cladded plastic, and sort of standard sort of wood cladding, but everything we were looking at with the wood was the damp was going to make it warp. Didn't fancy that and redoing the ceiling when it warped, so we opted for the plastic, and I'm really glad we did. It looks really nice, really clean, and yeah, chuffed to bits with it. So like I say, we shall see you on the next video, but thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.